大家好，欢迎收看杨澜访谈录。八月十号，中美男篮之间的首战呢，可以说是精彩纷呈，让人大呼过瘾。一边是主场作战却面临强敌的中国队，另一边呢是誓言雪耻要捍卫荣誉的美国队。虽然比赛的胜负并没有出乎人们的预料，但这也是在奥运比赛的历史上中美之间分差最小的一次比赛，可以说双方都打出了自己的精气神。其中呢，美国方面的灵魂人物之一科比布莱恩特在比赛中的表现是可圈可点。据我所知，自从来到了北京，他就对这出开场大戏非常期待。
科比来了，和美国篮球队的众明星们一起来参加北京奥运会。8月10日晚上22:15，美国队在本次奥运会的首场比赛就是对阵东道主中国队。虽然双方的实力存在一定差距，但是这场比赛还是吸引了众人关注，连美国总统布什都专门到场观战。
So your first team will be against the Chinese team, which is tough because this is their homeland.
What's
your anticipation of this game?
Well, my anticipation is it's going to be an incredible environment. I don't think we'll ever experience an environment like this ever again. I mean, this is going to be huge, and somebody had to play the home team first. I guess we have that task, and we're all excited about it. I mean, it's just a great opportunity to have the ultimate stage and play in the Olympics.
Have you heard about what Yao Ming said about this first game against the
US? No, I didn't.
He said if the Chinese team could win the American team, he would retire. Because that would be the prime moment for his career. Well, do you think there's a chance?
Well, there's definitely a chance, but I do think that hearing him said that, I don't think any of his hometown fans want to see him retire. Nobody wants to see
y'all
retire.
So you have to win?
No, so I think you guys should just boo them and make sure that, you know, that doesn't happen.
Yao Ming 的确没有机会退役，比赛没有悬念的以美国队的胜利告终。所有人都明白，这场胜利只是开始。对于科比和美国队来说，他们的目标只有一个。
The gold is the only target.
Well, it's yes for
and
us.
And winning silver is a failure in a way, right?
Well, for us it is. I mean, there's been so much emphasis placed on us winning a gold medal. That's pretty much the case for us.
Which country or countries team pose the biggest challenge to the American team this time?
For us, we really focus on every game. And I mean, everybody knows about, you know, the big...
No, come on, you have your key competitors. You can't take every one of them as a
key
competitor.
No, everybody's a competitor for us. You know, but I think that if people were making big news stories or teams they wanted to talk about, the teams that they talk about right off the top are Argentina, Spain, and Greece. Mm-hmm. But for us, the important thing is not to overlook anybody else. It's take it one game at a time and see where that goes.
从1989年国际篮联更改规则，允许职业球员参加国际篮球赛事以来， NBA 球星们组成美国国家篮球队，开始以其梦一般强大的实力被人称为梦之队。1992年，这支拥有乔丹等顶级球员的梦一队独霸天下，拿到巴塞罗那奥运会金牌。接着换血后的梦二、梦三队依旧天下无敌。但是随着国际篮球水平的迅猛发展，美国篮球渐渐失去了以往的统治地位。从2000年奥运会褪去光环、艰难卫冕的梦四队，到4年前的雅典奥运会三场败绩的噩梦队，人们开始明白，并非任何一支美国队都可以称之为梦之队。为了不让梦之队再次成为笑话，梦八队是带着复仇的决心来到北京的。
Since 2002, the U.S. team hasn't been performing very well on the international stage, and sometimes people even say the dream team is now a nightmare team. Of course, there's certain exaggeration in this, but what does that mean to the current American team? Are you ready to win back the respect and honor of the American team?
I hope so. I mean, we worked extremely hard, so we believe that we're ready to go.
So what does Coach K say to the team this time?
Well, he just says, guys,
how does he set your minds
to the games? Remember what you're playing for. Remember that you're playing for your country. Remember that you're going to have people back home pulling for you and supporting you and watching you. And kids that are growing up that are playing basketball now, they're going to be watching you and wanting you to do well. So, you know, when you're out there playing, remember who you're playing for.
But it seemed to us that in the past, American basketball professional players would take Olympic Games a little bit lighter than the professional matches.
Sure.
So you think the scenario is very different nowadays?
No, it's different now. It's different now.
How so?
Because this means more to us than winning an NBA championship. Mm-hmm. That's how. Mm-hmm. And we want to win a gold medal more than we want to win an NBA championship. Mm-hmm. So when you're that serious about it, it's a big change.
What do you say to yourself and to your colleagues in the team? Like, what does this Olympics mean to the U.S. team in basketball?
Well, I mean, there's a lot of pressure on it. You know, obviously, you know, we won bronze medals, but that just shows you how important the game of basketball is in the United States of America, because you can't win bronze. You have to win gold. You can't finish second. You can't finish third. You have to finish first. Mm-hmm. And, you know, for us, it's, you know, it's added pressure, but it comes with the job, and we actually like it.
Is there a sense of frustration over there?
No, I don't think there's a sense of frustration. I think there's a sense of anticipation. We can't wait to get started. You know, we understand this is a great opportunity, and we're just ready to go.
So, what's the point that the former U.S. teams failed to do, while you believe this team can do?
Well, in talking to some of the guys who were on those teams, you know, the first thing that they say is that everybody wasn't together, and not necessarily, you know, on
because
the court.
Because of what?
I think, you know, you had different relationships on the team, like, you know, three guys would hang out here, two guys would be together over here.
You know, I hate that guy.
Right, like that sort of thing. Like guys, you know, that really necessarily didn't get along or weren't together. I mean, this whole team, you know, we're all very, very close. And it's just because of our personalities. They're very compatible. And,